option, going right, cuts it up. He stopped. He stopped at the 2-yard line as Garland came up with Blakely.
For Jaquan Blakely, it was important for him to lead Tennessee on the right foot, which is why he elected to stay for his 6th year.
I feel like this year I've been more focused than I've ever been. I had unfinished business. There was things here that I felt like I didn't accomplish that I wanted to accomplish, and things that I haven't seen that I wanted to see and I wanted to do here at the University of Tennessee. Me being a 6-year, me being what they call me, an old guy. Just, you know, getting the young guys on board, you know, keeping positivity, going around in the locker room, things of that nature. Making sure everybody's on their P's and Q's, know what to do, know what we expect, keep everything at a high standard.
Blakely's leadership has been felt on the field. The 6-year, or old guy, as his teammates would call him, has been one of the top defensive linemen for Tennessee this season.
Some of my goals this season was to just better my tape, you know, work on myself as an individual and as a leader. Also, just to get Tennessee back to where Tennessee used to be. I mean, we, the past couple of years, we haven't had the best record, you know, haven't played the best, but I feel like since I stayed, you know, and I helped everybody get right and get going, you know, I feel like we've been doing pretty good.
The coaching staff have also played a big role in Blakely's development.
They're coaches, players. I mean, they're about us, you know, and the things that we like and the things that we want, you know. They're going to push us to be the best.
Defensive line coach Rodney Garner's tough love has also been an influence on Jaquan's play.
He's a great guy. He pushes us to be our best, and he's going to get the best from you, you know. But he's also going to have fun, and we're going to cut up from time to time. But when it's time for business, it's time for business. He always tells us he's not coaching the player, he's coaching the play. So, I mean, it makes it easier to take what he's saying, even though he's saying it as harshly as he is. It makes it take what he's saying very easy and to know that he's not on you, he's on the play.
During his 6 years on Rocky Top, a lot has changed, except for the people who motivate him, his family.
They've had my back through it all, you know, through thick and thin. They come to all my games, no matter where it is. Like, my mom tries to get there any way possible. They also just the love that we have, you know, it's unreal, you know. My family we've been through some tough things, so like, to just know that like we're overcoming the things that we've been through and things of that nature, it's just uplifting and very encouraging. My mom calls me every morning. Every week she calls me on Tuesday and gives me her breakdown of what she sees with the team. It's very interesting because sometimes she's actually on point with what she says, and then sometimes I'm like, all right, mommy, you need to do some more searching. But she does her own little scouting report that I get every Tuesday from her. With me being a big brother of two younger siblings, you know, and then me being the old guy here, it's just like, at home I have two little siblings. Here I have 170 little siblings. So, I mean, it makes it a whole lot easier just to know that I can show tough love to them and they know that I'm coming from a love standpoint.
With over half of the season behind him, Jay is focused on one game at a time and helping lead the defensive line.
Just take it one day at a time, one game at a time. I mean, that's all we can do. We can just worry about who we got up next. You know, these games are big, but it's only big because it's the next one. Just going into it, you know, you got to have a clear head and just got to know the task at hand. Basically, with the D-line, is just, man, we got to play hard. We got to continue to do what we're doing, continue to move the meter as the season goes along. We're coming up on it, and we're looking for a bowl game. So let's get a bowl game, you know what I'm saying, and send the seniors out right. But just get better as a unit, as a team, and just move the meter and just keep going.
For the Josh Heupel Show, I'm Casey Funderburg.